Please.
ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शांति शांति शांति। ॐ नमः। पाणिनि कात्यायन पतंजलिभ्यः शब्द विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंश ऋषिभ्यो महद्भ्यो मुनिभ्यो गुरुभ्यः केयोरान विभूषयन्ति पुरुषं हारान चंद्रोज्वला न स्नानं न विलेपनं न कुसुमं नालंकृता मूर्धजा वाण्येका समलंकरोति पुरुषं या संस्कृता धार्यते क्षीयन्ते खलु भूषणानि सततं वाग्भूषणं भूषणं। वेलकम टू संस्कृत फॉर द बिगिनर्स। दिस इज अवर फिफ्थ क्लास, बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली वी कुड नॉट मीट ऑन द लास्ट प्रीवियस क्लास एज वी कुड नॉट कनेक्ट अवरसेल्फ टू द सर्वर। सो अदरवाइज दिस इज द फोर्थ क्लास एंड वी आर विद द बुक संस्कृत स्वाध्याय प्रथम दीक्षा। वी जस्ट स्टार्टेड ऑफ विद द फर्स्ट पेज इन द प्रीवियस क्लास। वी हैड कम टू द जस्ट फर्स्ट पेज हैविंग फिनिश्ड द अक्षरमाला। From today, any word which has to be shown how to write can be shown because we have a board here. So that will be displayed, and viewers and students who are beginning to learn can view and learn more from this. So we are on page 1 of this book, Vakya Vyavaharaha. Here you are introduced to the simple pronoun and a noun. Nouns and pronouns are introduced here in a singular form. In Sanskrit, every noun has a singular, there are three numbers actually. One number is extra, which is not there in the world languages. No living language in the world has this extra number, which is there only retained in the Sanskrit. We have in all the languages, including Indian languages, singular and plural. We have book, books, boy, boys. But in Sanskrit, we have a book, two books and books. So we have an extra number. It is there, and therefore we have to... Why it is there, nobody has explained, but we can reason out. Why this extra number, dvivachana, what we call the dual number, singular, plural, common to all languages of the world. But this dual number, dvivachana, ekavachana, vivachana, bahuvachana. When you cross dvivachana, number 2, dual number, you are entering into plurality, bahuvachana. So Sanskrit is perhaps consider whatever is there between two people is still between two people. The moment this the information crosses the two people, it goes to the large number of people. So to this effect we have one saying also in Panchatantra, Chatushkarno Mantraha Sthiraha Bhavet. Any secrecy, any musing, any thought that is shared by Chatushkarna of two people is going to be very firm. Shatkarno Vidyate Mantraha, and whatever is heard by Shatkarna, Shatkarna means three people having two ears. So whatever is heard by three people is no secrecy. So perhaps the number, dual number, the Dvivachana developed in Sanskrit to keep up this secrecy between two people. Whatever is shared by two people is supposed to be secret, like Guru and Shishya. It can be anything else also. So more than two is plural in Sanskrit. Please bear this in mind. Singular, plural is common to all of us, but in Sanskrit, coming over to Sanskrit, we have an extra number that is dual number. But here in the book, we are starting off with singular noun and singular, and likewise, whatever pronoun, whatever adjective follows the noun, it has to be derived in the same number. Whatever number is the subject, the noun, the number of the pronoun or adjective will be the same. So here you are introduced, you can see the page, Eshaha Balakaha, with pictures it is introduced here. Now this Eshaha is a pronoun coming from the Etad pronoun, Dakaranta Etad Shabda. So we will perhaps little later analyze where that this Eshaha, the word Eshaha is coming from, what is the base of this. Balakaha, Balakaha is a very simple word in Sanskrit. Balaha or Balakaha, a boy, young boy is called Balakaha, Kapratya. So Eshaha Balakaha, this is a boy. As I told in my previous class, in Sanskrit we have a lot of economizing of the words. Ekakshara Laghavam Sutam Manyante Vayakarana. There is a saying in Sanskrit grammarians, among the grammarians, even if there is an economy of a syllable, one syllable, the grammarians consider it as having a son born. So much joy they have. So economizing is one aspect of Sanskrit is and Sanskrit grammar. So here in this sentence, this is a sentence, Eshaha Balakaha, which translated into English would mean this is a boy. As I said earlier, is auxiliary verb, article A are not required in Sanskrit. If I use it, it will be like this. Eshaha, ekaha, balakaha, asti. If I have to use to show you how this English sentence is in English, this is a boy for words. So if I have to say the same thing in Sanskrit, eshaha, ekaha, balakaha, asti. Ekaha and asti, both are in a way not at all required in Sanskrit, because they are understood from the sentence context, because the picture of one boy is there, therefore he got to be singular, and eshaha is a pronoun. This is mostly understood. Eshaha balakaha asti is not necessary. If written, there is no mistake, but otherwise there is no necessity as such. So eshaha is a this, referring to a boy who is very close to me. And opposite side you are shown saha balakaha. There is a gap shown between the pronoun the saha and balakaha, showing that is a boy. This eshaha becomes saha in saying that, demonstrative. Saha balakaha, that is a boy, and there also again the verb and the article are understood. So like that, this introduction of a simple noun and a simple pronoun is used here. Eshaha Simhaha. Now you can understand, those who know little, have little knowledge of Sanskrit, Simha, lion, this is a lion. Saha Simhaha, that is a lion. Eshaha Vanaraha would mean, this is a monkey. In English we have to fully say, this is a monkey. Saha Vanaraha, that is a monkey, that is a monkey. Eshaha Gajaha, this is an elephant, this is an elephant. Saha Gajaha, that's an elephant, that is an elephant. So please try to understand these two, and this one word pronoun Eshaha standing for this, a person who is very close at hand, and Saha pronoun stands for that, and we refer to a person who is far, a little away from you, away from you, then we say saha balakaha, saha pita, saha janakaha, saha adhyapakaha, and so on and so forth. You can say any, you can use any of the noun in the singular form with this saha. Saha vrikshaha, you can say saha manavaha, you can say anything. Then some more examples are given on page 2. Eshaha balakaha, saha vriddaha. Again, this repeated, saha vriddaha. That is an, or he is an old man. When we translate into English, saha vriddaha, we can say that is an old man or he is an old man. He also can be translated, because basically saha means he. Sometimes depending on the following word, it can be translated that. We'll see that sentence later. Saha balakaha mama putraha, if I say. Saha balakaha mama putraha, that boy. I will have to demonstrate this. सीलिंग Now here, saha balakaha. We said there saha vruddaha. He is an old man. Here saha means he, but here when it is immediately followed by a noun, it means that. Saha balakaha, that boy, mama, my putraha, son. That boy is my son. This means that. So what I mean to say here, saha means he, saha also means that, depending on a sentence like this shown on the board. We will understand that also very clearly. I will be showing you later. Then eshaha simhaha, very simple. Eshaha simhaha, this is a lion. Somewhat repeated, doesn't matter. Saha harinaha. Now the nouns are changed here. Eshaha simhaha, this is a lion. Saha harinaha, that is an antelope or a deer. Eshaha vanaraha, this is a monkey. Saha bhallukaha, that's a bear. Now here we don't say in English saha bhallukaha, he is a bear. We generally don't say he is a bear, that is a bear. Similarly, saha harinaha, that is a deer, that is an antelope. Eshaha gajaha, this is an elephant. Saha ashwaha, that is a horse. We do not say generally he is a horse. Though horse is masculine, we don't say. All these are masculine nouns here, which are presented in these two pages. Then going to the third page, Eshaha mayuraha. Mayuraha, from the picture you can see it is a peacock. This is a peacock. And saha shukaha, that's a parrot. Eshaha dandaha, this is a stick. So eshaha stands for this, saha stands for that or he or that. Saha vrikshaha, that's a tree. Eshaha bhikshukaha, bhikshukaha meaning a beggar, a person who is seeking something. You can see from the picture, this is a beggar. Saha nrupaha, and that is a king, or you can say he is a king. Either you can say he is a king or that is a king. Eshaha chhatraha, chhatraha standing for student. From the picture you can see he is carrying a bag also on his back. This is a student. Saha adhyapakaha, and on the opposite side we find that is a teacher. Adhyapakaha means a teacher. So like this, a simple noun in the one singular form and pronoun are introduced here. It's eshaha and saha. Moving on, there is some abhyasa, practice. Whatever you have read in three pages, you may practice here with the same pronouns, remembering these two pronouns. One is eshaha and that is saha. So when the picture is closer, you have to use eshaha. You can also say, Srinivas garu, eshaha balakaha, this is a boy, which means. Then what do you say? Saha simhaha, that's a lion. Saha simhaha. We cannot say eshaha. If you say eshaha simhaha, would be also right if it is very close to you. If it is not close by, then you say saha. Eshaha, next. Vriddhaha. Eshaha vriddhaha. This is an old man. And then saha tarunaha. He is a young man. Taruna in Sanskrit means young man. Saha tarunaha. Only two words. Saha tarunaha. He is an old, I mean young man, sorry. Then हियर इज वन वर्ड एषः चषकः दिस इज अ ग्लास एषः चषकः सः घटः दैट्स अ पॉट सः घटः एंड देन एषः मीनः दिस इज अ फिश एंड वी हैव ऑन द ऑपोजिट साइड सः मकरः मकरः मीन्स अ क्रोकोडाइल So we have to, now by now, it is so easy to pick up the pronoun esha and sa, this and that or he, this person, that person, and using with the nouns introduced here. Several nouns, some of them may be known to you, some may not be known to you. And moving on further, now here the opposite, the picture is changed, the far picture is given first and the near picture is given later. So you have to say, how do you say the ninth one? Saha Sukaha. Saha Sukaha. That is a parrot. That is a parrot. And then when the picture is close by, Eshaha Mayuraha. Eshaha Mayuraha. This is a peacock. And then likewise. So he is alternately changing here. Watch carefully the distance and then use. How do you use here? 11th one. Eshaha Chandraha. Eshaha Chandraha. This is a moon. This is the moon. Then we say Saha Suryaha. That is the sun. That is the sun. Now this way again. Eshaha Saha here. Saha 13th one. Because this is far away. So we suppose Esha is not to be used here. Saha Bidalaha. Bidalaha is a cat. That is a cat. And Eshaha Kukkuraha or Shunakaha. We have many words here, but Kukkuraha is used. Kukkuraha meaning a dog. Eshaha Kukkuraha. This is a dog. Then Eshaha Gajaha. This is an elephant. And Saha Mushakaha. Mushikaha or Mushakaha. Mushakaha means a mouse, rat. So that is a rat. So by this way, this is a rapid learning book as the book caption is there. Teach yourself. There is some guidance is required, but if you are already familiar with the alphabet, then you can pick up these words and the sentences, small sentences. Now, having done this, so far in the four pages, what we have seen? We have seen a masculine noun like Balakaha, Vriddaha, Tarunaha, a masculine noun is introduced and a masculine pronoun correspondingly is introduced. Now in the next lesson immediately you are going to be introduced to a feminine noun. How is a feminine noun in singular number is used in Sanskrit and correspondingly the pronoun also changes into feminine. In Sanskrit we cannot use a masculine pronoun with a feminine noun or a feminine pronoun with a masculine noun. So the concord or this agreement should be there. If the noun is important in Sanskrit, noun is the important factor, subject is important. So whatever is the gender of the subject, whatever is the number of the subject, that goes with the pronoun also. So if the subject is masculine, the pronoun is masculine. If the subject is singular, pronoun is singular. So that is where we are introduced here to the feminine noun. So nouns are like this in Sanskrit. We have started off what we have seen just now. A noun in the this we call it as akaranta. Akarantaha pumlinga. That is what we are introduced to. Akaranta pumlinga. Now what you are going to see akaranta this is not necessary but just I am telling you akaranta కొంచెం ప్రాక్టీస్ దిస్ ఈస్ స్త్రీ ఇన్ షార్ట్ ఫర్ స్త్రీలింగ ఫెమినైన్ Pum, Pum Linga, for I am written in a very abbreviated form. Pum means Pum Linga, masculine. Akaranta, masculine. This Balaka is Akaranta. Tarunaha, whatever words we have come across in the first 3-4 pages, they belong to this Akaranta. This meaning Akaranta, a noun ending in the vowel A, Akara. As I told in my previous lectures, Kara does not mean anything. It only refers to this. Akara. When I say Akara, it is only a letter. Akaranta means, in other words, A ending. A ending. When I say Akaranta, it means A ending. A ending only. This is what it means. So you are introduced here to Akaranta Strilinga, feminine nouns ending in A sound. Esha. Now the pronoun, you can watch, the pronoun is changed from Saha to Esha. Esha, Eshaha, it was in masculine Eshaha. Here it is becoming Esha. Esha Balika. If you remember, in the previous pages we have seen Eshaha Balakaha, that is there. Esha Balaka I have not written, Saha Balaka is written. Esha Balakaha in the previous pages. This is a boy. What is then opposite in gender sentence? Esha Balika. See the Esha changing to Esha. There is some elongation. Esha is becoming Esha. This is a girl, Balika. Now one can very easily understand, those who are familiar with Sanskrit vocabulary, Balakaha is a boy, Balika, then there is a Dirgha here. Balika means girl. Then on the opposite side, that Saha, what we saw earlier so far, Saha Balakaha, Saha Adhyapakaha, becoming Sa in feminine form. So what is gone there? The Visarga is gone. Saha becomes Sa. Sa means she. Sa means also that. Sa Balika. She is a girl. She is a girl, or that is a girl. You can write in both ways. That is a girl. Esha Lata. This is a creeper. Now you can see from the picture, the Lata, creeper in Sanskrit, is feminine. And therefore, it is given a feminine pronoun. Esha Lata, this is a creeper. Sa Lata, that is a creeper. We don't say, we cannot say in English, she is a creeper, because the gender of the creeper is, we cannot literally translate into English, she is a creeper. No, we can. See, what is, how is it decided, how is the gender decided in Sanskrit of the nouns? It's very difficult. No, even the greatest grammarian cannot tell you. It's only by practice that you have to, when you have doubt, when we have doubt, we have to consult the dictionary. What must be the gender of a particular word? We have to only go to the dictionary and see it is so. Mostly, but on an observation, it is found all male persons are given masculine nouns, and all things which are relating to feminine things which are feminine are given feminine gender. Now Lata being a creeper, which is a part of the nature, nature is lovely, and therefore nature is supposed to be mother nature, we say, and feminine. And with that reasoning, Lata is a feminine noun. So Sa Lata, that is a creeper. Esha Shatika. Shatika for foreigners is something new. Shatika is a typical big cloth sari, what we call sari in English, Indian English, which is worn by all Indian women, mostly in the South India. All South Indian women put on this sari, which is running into 6 meters, 5 meters cloth. You can see women putting on this sari. So that is called Shatika. This is a sari. Sa Shatika, that is a sari. Here also, again, instead of saying that is a sari, you don't say she is a sari. that would be a blunder in English. So sa has to be very carefully understood and translated depending on the following noun. You can say sa balika, she is a girl. Sa vidyarthini, she is a student. Sa mata, she is mother, she is a mother. But you cannot say sa shatika, she is a sari. How can we say she is a sari? So that is a sari. Esha mala, you can see from the picture, this is a garland, rosary, or you can say rosary. Sa mala, that is a rosary. So if you watch on this page, balika is a word ending in akaranta, lata, akaranta, shatika, akaranta, mala, akaranta. So what is happening here? All these are a-ending nouns and therefore they are feminine. Mostly when a noun in Sanskrit ends in long vowel, mostly, exceptions are there, it is supposed to be a feminine noun. We have also akaranta pullinga shabda, but we don't introduce that in the beginning to the beginners and confuse them. So generally speaking, any noun that is ending in a longer vowel, lata, nadi, gauri, vadhu, so we'll slowly go from a to onwards. So this is how the feminine noun balika, the feminine pronoun esha is introduced in this page, and some more exercise we have to do. Esha balika, chapandi, you can speak. How do you translate this?
This is
a girl. This is a girl. Then sa vruddha.
Sa vruddha.
The picture. She is an old woman. She is an old woman. See these so many four letters. She is an old woman. Five words have to be there in English to make a sentence complete. But in Sanskrit, simply I say sa vruddha. Sa vruddha nari asti. Vruddha itself means a old lady, an old lady. If I say the same in masculine, it becomes vruddha with the visarga. Vruddha, saha vruddha. Opposite sa vruddha. She is an old woman. So next, esha lata. This is a creeper. Sa
kalika.
Kalika. Sa kalika. Kalika means a bud. Bud. B-U-D. Bud. That's a bud. Bud is also feminine. So whatever is relating to nature is feminine. Kalika. Kalika. Pronounce it. Sa kalika. Sa kalika. That is a bird. Esha shatika. We have already seen. This is a sari. Sa petika. You can see from the picture, those who do not know, what does a petika mean? It's a box. It's a box. That's a box. That is a box. And esha mala. This is a rosary. Rosary. Japa mala, like rosary. Sa devata. Now here we have a picture of a goddess here. Sa devata. So that is a goddess. She is a goddess. Goddess. Sa devata. So this way you are slowly introduced to the masculine and feminine nouns without telling in detail what I have said now, akaranta, akaranta, without telling them. You are introduced to a singular noun in masculine and a singular noun in feminine gender, and correspondingly a singular, masculine pronoun this, masculine, feminine pronoun this is also introduced, and opposite that also. So we may go in for some reading here. Next page, page 8. Esha, esha chhatra. As you can see from the picture, this is a student, or she is a student. This is a student. We better translate it as this is a student. Girl student. If you have to be more clear, this is a girl student. Sa adhyapika, meaning she is a lady teacher. She is a lady teacher, or you can say that is a lady teacher. We can translate in two ways, understand in two ways. That's a lady teacher, or she is a lady teacher. Then coming to the Esha Patrika. Patrika is a paper, newspaper. This is a newspaper. Sa Pustika. Pustika, that's a book. Now a book, we have a book in feminine also here. Sa Pustika, that is a book. And it is given in feminine. Esha Patashala. Esha Patashala. Patashala. Patashala meaning a school. This is a school. This is a school. Sa Goshala. Somewhat rhyming. Patashala opposite Goshala. Goshala means cow. Cow pen. Where cows are stationed. Goshala. Cow pen. Sa Goshala. Esha Makshika. You can see from the picture. This is a fly. F-L-Y. Fly. This is a fly. Sa Pipilika. Sa. That is a... what do you call? Ant. That is an ant. Pipilika is ant. Makshika is a fly. So this way, there are so many things feminine. Now, we cannot reason out why Pustaka, a book, is feminine, put in feminine. If somebody has a doubt, well, sir, you have said just now whatever is relating to feminine like and relating to nature are feminine, but how does this come under feminine gender? Well, there is no reason. I cannot give you reason, nobody can give you reason. So, Pipilika. Then we move on to the next page. Esha Saraswati. This is Goddess Saraswati. This is Goddess Saraswati. Sa Parvati. That is Parvati, or she is Parvati. Parvati, the wife of Lord Shiva. Esha Janani. Janani in Sanskrit means mother. Janani, Janma Bhumischa. Like Esha Janani. This is a mother. Sa Bhagini. And the opposite side, Sa, that is a sister, or she is a sister. That is a sister, she is a sister. Bhagini means sister. Esha Lekhani. As you can see, this is a pen. Now, reason cannot be given here. Pen is feminine in Sanskrit. Lekhani. Lekhani. Now, slowly on this page, if you are watching, we are reading nouns ending in E vowel. I'll come from the back. Saraswati, Janani, Parvati, Bhagini, Lekhani, Ankani. All these nouns are ending in the vowel E. Vowel E, which is long vowel. We are passing slowly. Akaranta, Akaranta, Ekaranta, Ekaranta. Like Saraswati, Janani, Gauri, Nadi, etc. Lekhani. Lekhani is feminine. We have to take it. This is a pen. Sa Ankhani. That is a pencil. Pencil is called Ankhani. Esha Ghati. And even a clock is supposed to be feminine in Sanskrit. So we use Esha. I cannot use Esha Ghati, which does not match. Esha Ghati, I cannot say. Esha Ghati. This is a clock. Timepiece. Sa Kartari. That is a scissors. Now even scissors is feminine here. Kartari. Sa Kartari. That's a scissors. Esha Darvi. Darvi, a spoon. This is a spoon. And again the word E Karanta. Sa Chalani. This is a sieve. What is called in English? Sieve. S-I-E-V-E. Sieve. With which you filter some eatables. Sieve. So these are all, watch on page 9. You are introduced to nouns ending in E Karanta. I may write out here. is becoming hard, I don't know why. Nouns ending in E vowel, E karanta. On page 9, all these Saraswati, Parvati, Janani, Bhagini, Lekhani, Ankani, Ghati, Kartari, Darvi, Chalani, these are all E karanta nouns. Please watch carefully. We have come from akara, akara to E kara. Step by step, we are going in an alphabetic manner. We may now move on to Abhyasa, Dvitiya Abhyasa, second lesson in this part. Now you are supposed to do some exercise here for your learning. Fill in the blanks here. Looking at the picture, now Lata is there. So what do you use? Lata is masculine or feminine?
Feminine.
So which pronoun you take here? Esha Lata. This is a creeper. Yes. Now Balika is a feminine. So
Sa Balika.
Then here Petika. Esha Petika. Sa Shatika. So here we are. Esha, sa. These are the feminine pronouns here. Esha and sa. So these are, you are supposed to use this. Esha petika, sa shatika. Then what do you use here in the fifth one? The picture is a little away. So, sa, page 10.
Sa lekhani.
That is a pen. And then here, sa, esha ankani. This is a pencil. Now, how we are deciding whether to use esha or sa depending on the distance here from the picture. So, if the picture is far, then we say sa lekhani. When the pencil is closer, then we say esha ankhani. This is a pencil, right? Seventh one. What do you use?
Esha churika.
Esha churika. This is a knife. And then on the opposite side, sa. Chalani. That is a sieve, as I said, sieve. Now, on the other side of the 11th page, we have again some practice required. What comes here, Srinivas? Esha Kartari. This is a scissors. Esha Kartari. And the opposite?
Sa Vellani.
Vellani is a typical instrument used in India for making chapatis. So this may not be known to the foreigners, those who are watching this. This vellani is a held by two hands. When dough is made of flour, wheat flour, and put on the ground on some stone, and then with the help of this vellani, women roll the dough into a chapati. What do you call chapati? Pulkas, whatever you say. So we use this making our chapatis, pulkas, you know, it's a kind of, they are available in America, I have seen. Chapatis are available in New Jersey, New York area. They are ready made and available. So sa vellani, that is, I don't know what to say in English, vellani. You can say roti maker. We can call it a roti maker. It's a wooden instrument. You can see it's a very like a cylinder in the middle, and the to hold the on both the sides hands are there. So vellani. So 11-1. Esha mala. This is a rosary. So what do you use for this? Sa
lata.
That is a creeper. And here esha ghati. This is a clock. Sa dvichakrika. Now a word is coined here for cycle, bicycle. Dvi means two. Chakra means wheels. Cycle, a bicycle which has two wheels is called dvichakrika, and it's feminine. So sa dvichakrika, that is a bicycle. Now here down. Sa adhyapika, that is a teacher, or she is a lady teacher. She is a lady teacher. That is a lady teacher, or she is a lady teacher. And the 16th one. Esha chhatra. And this is a girl student. This is a girl student. So this is how you are supposed to learn these pronouns. The pronouns are always going with the noun, feminine pronoun, masculine noun, masculine pronoun. Noun pronoun you are using, and the rest of the things are understood, like articles and verbs, auxiliary verbs are understood. Then dhyanena patantu, please read carefully on page 12. We move on to page 12. Now etat, now you are coming to, now having seen through the masculine noun, masculine pronoun, feminine noun, feminine pronoun, we are coming to neuter pronoun and neuter pronoun. So like in languages we have three genders, masculine, feminine and neuter. So this completes the circle of genders. So here comes the neuter gender words with the neuter pronouns. Phalam, phalam, you can see, phalam means a fruit. A fruit is neuter. And therefore, we don't take here esha phalam, I don't say. I would never dare say esha phalam, because esha is feminine pronoun, esha is masculine pronoun, and I would have to say etat phalam. This is a fruit. So the pronoun has changed from esha to esha, and now to etat. Basically it is etat. We'll see that now. And the in the other side we find tat phalam. Tat, we don't say saha, we don't say sa, we say tat. Like in the Mahavakyas, those who know, tatvamasi, tatvamasi, tat means that. Tat phalam, that is a fruit. Then we read etat vimanam. One can very easily know what is vimana. Is an aeroplane. This is an aeroplane. Tat vimanam, that's an aeroplane. Now see etat vyajanam. Vyajanam is again a typical Indian handmade fan made out of palm leaves. It's a fan made with palm leaves. And when there is current off in India, frequently we get electricity shut down, and we take the help of this and call it vyajanam. It's a fan. Etat vyajanam. If you remove from etat a, that becomes tat. Tat, that it becomes tat vyajanam. That's a fan. Etat dugdham. Dugdham meaning milk. This is milk. Milk word in Sanskrit is neuter. Etat dugdham, tat dugdham. So this way we are introduced here to the neuter noun with the corresponding neuter pronoun. And etat palam, this is a fruit. And opposite tat pushpam, even pushpam is neuter in Sanskrit. Patram pushpam palam thoyam, all are neuter there in Gita. So tat pushpam, that is a fruit, flower. Etat phalam, tat pushpam. Etat vimanam, tat lokayanam. Now here is a word used by our, recent, coined by our Indian Indian Sanskritis in the recent times. I think there has been no word like this, but it is coined word. Tat Lokayanam. You can see the picture, those who are watching. Lokayanam is a public transport bus. What to say, it is a bus. So Lokayanam. Yanam refers to vehicle. Lokayanam is a public transporting bus. Lokayanam. Tat Lokayanam. Etat Vyajanam. This is a fan. Tat Bhavanam. Bhavanam referring to a big palace, like building. A building or a palace. That's a building or that is a palace. Etat Dugdham. Dugdham. This is milk. Tat Jalam. That is water. Jalam is neuter in Sanskrit. Therefore, Tat Jalam. That is water. Now, all of these you can convert this way, that way also. For example, Etat Phalam. You can make it Tat Phalam. And everywhere you can exchange the etat with tat, tat with etat, depending on the requirement. Then on page 14, we come to page 14, more nouns are introduced here, neuter nouns. Etat netram, netram nayanam, this is the eye, this is an eye. And tat upanetram, now this is also a coined word. Upanetram, spectacle. This is what is closely worn by us on the eye. Upa, samipe, very samipa to the netra, therefore spectacles. Upanetram refers to spectacle. Etat vatayanam. You can see the picture. Vatayanam means a window. This is a window. Tat sopanam. Tat sopanam. That is a staircase. You can see. Etat gruham. You can see the picture and understand. This is a house. This is a home. Tat udyanam. That's a garden. Well, garden must be green, but here everything is reddish. So I am giving you the meaning. Tat udyanam. The entire book is printed in red. Not in multicolor, it's single color. So that is a problem here. Etat parnam. This is a leaf. This is a leaf. Tat sasyam. That is a crop. Sasyam referring to crop. It looks some crop here, maize. Tat sasyam. That's a crop. Now we had, after practicing these three pages, from page 12, page 13, page 14, deal with neuter nouns and neuter pronouns, and a little practice on the abhyasa. So we complete two abhyasas here, and third abhyasa is coming up here, and you are supposed to fill in the blanks with the appropriate pronoun. How do you decide the pronoun? By the looking at the pictures, nearness or farness. If it is near, you use the appropriate near pronoun. Otherwise, the pronoun which refers to a distance. So, what is the first one you use, Srinivas? Etat Viman. And when using this pronoun, you got to look at the noun also. By now, you are introduced to three genders, knowingly or unknowingly, without telling anything. But I have told on the board, I have explained. Firstly, you are introduced to masculine gender. Secondly, you are introduced to feminine gender. And just we finished the neuter gender. So by now, we should have that comprehension. Which word is masculine? Which word is feminine? Which word is neuter? And how do we go with? Mostly, I am giving you a general rule. Any word which is having the visarga, the two vertical dots, or circles, is supposed to be a masculine gender. Any word in Sanskrit which is ending in long vowel like Balika, Kanya, Lata, Parvati, any A, E, it is supposed to be feminine. Any noun that ends in the word Am, Jalam, Pushpam, Lokayanam, Vimanam, Am sound, and that is supposed to be a neuter noun. So that is the general way to remember these nouns. So you are right. Etat vimanam. This is an aeroplane. Then which pronoun you used? Tat railayanam. Now this is rail. We have taken English some part and put Sanskrit suffix there. Railayanam. This is a train. That is a train. Sorry, that is a train. This is an aeroplane. That is a train. Third one.
Tat vatayanam.
That is a window. That's a window. Yes. Etat vyajanam. This is a fan. Hand held fan. Etat vyajanam. Fifth one.
Etat
gruham. This is a house or this is a home. Then tat mandiram. That's a temple. That is a temple. Now all these nouns are here neuter only. So no worry. Here tat pushpam. That's a flower. That's a flower. Etat parnam. This is a leaf. This is a leaf. So this is how you proceed. Looking at the picture, looking at the noun and deciding its gender, you use the appropriate pronoun. We are still with the neuter nouns. No, don't worry. On the 16th page. Yes.
Etat udyanam.
Etat udyanam. This is a garden. Tat sopanam. That's a staircase. Yes, here. 11th.
Tat upanetram.
Here the picture is little far. Therefore, tat upanetram. That is a spectacle. Then,
etat chhatram.
As you can see, this is an umbrella. Chhatram. Yes.
Etat pustakam.
Now, you may have some doubt here. We have on page one word, a feminine word, used for book. On page 8, we have pustika. Pustika is given in feminine gender. Pustakam is given in neuter gender. Both mean and refer to a book. So, we go by the noun only. If it is pustakam, we say etat. If it is pustika, we say esha. Corresponding pronoun we have to take. Then 14th one.
Kridanakam.
Say it properly. Tat kridanakam. Tat kridanakam. Kridanakam is a toy. Kridanakam, a toy. That's a toy. Next.
Tat netram.
That is an eye. That's an eye. Yes. Etat patram. This is a
paper.
This is a paper. Now you have got to fill up likewise on page, next page 17, some abhyasa is read, you fill in the blanks here. How do you fill up this? Now watch, we are coming to nouns which are jumbled up, masculine, feminine, neuter. So watch carefully the noun and take the appropriate pronoun. So balaka, so which pronoun you prefer?
Saha balakaha.
Good. Then gruham is new. What gender it is? Gruham. Just now I told you. Aha sound. Visarga masculine mostly. E, A is feminine. Am is neuter. So gruham. So which pronoun you pick up?
Etat
gruham. This is a home. Yes. Good. Third one. Look at the noun, samadarvi. Samadarvi is a spoon, flattened spoon. So which pronoun you would like to use here?
Esha
samadarvi. Esha samadarvi. This is a spoon. Then patashala, feminine, na? Patashala, feminine only. So sa patashala, sa, that is a school. That is a school. Now, dugdham, look at the noun. And what gender it could be? It is neuter. Napumsaka. Therefore, etat dugdham. Etat dugdham. See the word nadi. it is feminine, bound to be feminine because it is long ending, and therefore esha nadi, this is a river, this is a river. Then in the seventh one,
esha
chhatra, when you are looking at chhatra, it is a feminine, a girl student. Therefore esha, I cannot use here eshah, I cannot use here etat. I have to only necessarily match this gender by the appropriate esha. Esha chhatra, this is a girl student. And likewise parnam is neuter, so tat parnam, tat parnam. This is how you have to learn, by looking at the noun. Noun is all the more important, all the most important factor in sentence making in Sanskrit is noun. Whatever is the gender of the noun, that will be followed by pronouns and things like that. So here something is told on page 18. Balakaha balika pustakam, balakaha balika pustakam. Now what is giving, the book is giving you three words in three genders, starting with masculine word, a feminine word, and a neuter word. Balakaha, a boy, balika, a girl, pustakam, a book. And on the other side also the same thing is repeated. Now you have to use picking up these pronouns given under with the respective masculine and so how do you pick up this eshaha?
Balakaha.
And since the other box is far away, little away, so you have to use these pronouns. Saha balakaha, eshaha balakaha, saha balakaha. Esha balika, matching with this, esha balika, sa balika. Etat pustakam, tat pustakam. So this is how you have to match. I may have to write to show you a little. What is the order? Sa. Chapani, Esha. Then Esha. Esha. Sa. एशा सा एम इच्छा ओ सॉरी दिस इज अ मिस्टेक कम टू राइट सह सॉरी सह सा बालिका यार पुस्तक can see this, or you can just have drawn a line here. Eshaha, esha, etat, saha, sa, tat. This is masculine, feminine, neuter. Masculine, feminine, neuter. Eshaha balakaha, esha balika, etat pustakam. So noun is matched by the pronoun. Saha balakaha, that's a boy. Sa balika, that's a girl. Tat pustakam, that's a, you can't say tat balakaha, nor can you say sa balakaha. We cannot play with this. This matching must be perfect. The agreement must be perfect. Balika feminine, therefore sa. If it is balakaha, then I take in this pronoun. This pronoun is this pronoun. This is that pronoun. So this is how you are supposed to. Time is almost over. Okay, we'll stop here for the next class. We'll be there. I can announce the time also. Our time is changing, na?
Yeah.
4 to 5. So Shubham Bhuyat.